Hi, and welcome to Katrin Figures. I'm your host, Caitlin, and today is the day of all days. It's New Comic Book Wednesday, which of course can only mean one thing. I have my pull box for you guys. So before I get on into the polls for this week, I would like to inform you how my day started with my local LCS, or my LCS, my local comic book store. So this was in my pull bag, in my box. Dear subscriber, if you were expecting any of the following series in your subscription and did not receive them, it is due to the fact that we have not yet received them from our distributor, who shall remain nameless.
Can I say it?
Sure. Can I say it? Anyway, moving on.
Oh, I thought you were keeping it nameless.
We should be getting them sometime, Wednesday the 6th. We are sorry for the inconvenience, and we'll be getting these books to you as soon as we can. Would you like to see the list of all of the books that they did not receive? So, as you can imagine, the wall was pretty barren when I walked in, and I opened up the shop. I like to open up my shop. So, believe it or not, on that list, I only had about 7 books that I was really, like, I need to get. So, it wasn't horrible starting out the day. So, this is my polls for that. So, since I was missing books, I just decided to do them all sporadically. So, first off is Alters, issue 8. I know the series isn't for everyone, but I really enjoyed the first arc, and I'm really excited to see where it goes moving forward. Next is The Jetsons, issue 2 out of 6. My shop did not have the Connor cover when I first went in, so I got this one. I'm not hating it, though. I'm not hating it. Next, I picked up Hawkeye, issue 13. This is the first legacy issue of it, and it's Family Reunion Part 1. I love mugshot covers, and I love both the Hawkeyes. Mark also loves both the Hawkeyes, so I thought this was just, I had to get it. Also, just a really good series so far. Also, they had the lenticular cover, which... this is a much better lenticular cover than some of the earlier ones. I feel like Marvel's stepped their game up because DC's basically sold them out like hotcakes. Next, I was on the fence whether or not to pick this up, but with as many books that were missing, it was on the shelf, and I was like, yeah, I should probably pick it up. And I picked up Witchblade. Issue 1. I understand this is a different Witchblade than what we remember. I've only read a handful of Witchblade stories, so hopefully this is good. I like the cover. The cover's beautiful. I like the colors on it. Next, I picked up Justice League, issue 34, and this is the first Christopher Priest storyline. And it is the new DC Universe logo right there. We no longer have the Rebirth banner. So definitely leaves more room for some artwork. Pretty excited about that. Next, I love this cover. And I love the fact that the giant Rebirth cover tagline is not right there, because we're able to see more of Batman's cape, and it looks great, especially the fact that we get the little icons for each individual character's thing. So I'm kind of chill with that. Next, I picked up Red Sonja, issue 11. I love the cover. Just a really great Red Sonja cover. I also picked up Superman, issue 36, of course, Superman on Darkseid's throne. Also picked up the variant cover, because why the hell not? It's a pretty great variant. in my opinion. I also picked up Batman the White Knight issue 3 main cover. Batman and TMNT issue 1 of 6. So this is a sequel to the first one, not the Adventures one that we got. This is a sequel, continuation of the New 52, much more serious version. So pretty excited about that. I love the cover for this. Next, I picked up Deathstroke. So this is issue 26. Again, I'm liking the target right there. Believe it or not, they actually had both covers for this, and that is Harley and Ivy Meet Betty and Veronica issue 3. So this is, I believe this is cover A, and then this is cover B. I don't know, I picked up both. I really liked both of them. So it's like, yep. They had to come home with me. And last, from the first time I went, Mark and I both decided that we needed to pick up Shirtless Bear Fighter, the trade paperback. I read it all in single issue, and I own all the single issues, but do I really want to go through and constantly break out single issues to read a story like this? No. So, got the trade. Definitely feel like it was worth it. All right, so, you know, disappointing that I was missing a couple different things. The holiday issue, the Eastman issue, you know, the Eastman cover of Batman TMNT. Very disappointing things. Quiet on set. Stop moving. They can hear you. But I went on to my shop's Facebook page, and I was just like, hey, so am I picking up my books tomorrow? And they actually got them in. So I have the rest of my books. So Batman the White Knight issue 3. I love this cover. I mean, the other variant covers for some of the earlier issues, but this is awesome. This I definitely had to get my hands on. Sorry, we live in a neighborhood. We have neighbors, unfortunately. I also really loved this cover and I wanted to get my hands on it, and that is Batman issue 36, the variant for it. Alright, there's not much room, so I'm gonna put this down here.
You have a few minutes left.
I also picked up DC's holiday special for 2017. I always love the holiday specials that they come out with, be it Halloween, you know, the holiday special, because they don't want to say Christmas, you know, any number of things. They're always a really great collection of stories. Also, we have a really great Andy Kubert cover here, so awesome. Next is Batman TMNT 2, issue 1. This is the Eastman variant. Pretty excited about that. They didn't have this in my bag, so I was really happy that I went back and actually found it on the wall, because they only had like 2 copies of it still sitting out. And that's Green Arrow, issue 35. So, and once again, continuing that right there. And next is Nightwing issue 34. My thing is, couldn't they have just come up with like the Nightwing symbol? Why did it have to be a bat? Yeah, just saying. They didn't have any other covers. It was the only cover they had, so I had to deal with it. Next is Doctor Strange issue 382. I kind of fell off Doctor Strange for a while, but then I picked it back up because Kate's took over the writing for it, and Loki is now the Sorcerer Supreme. I really loved the first issue that Kate's came out with, and I'm really I'm a huge fan of Loki, and I'm super pleased that he is in fact the Sorcerer Supreme now, and I'm really excited to see what Kate's is going to be doing with this. So definitely something I'm really into. So yeah, I was really, really excited that I was actually able to get all of my books and that I didn't have an issue where they sold them or, you know, all of them came in damaged or I'd have to wait several weeks for a few issues. So yeah, I'm still really, really pleased with that. So as always, give me a like if you like this video, comment below and tell me what you picked up at your local shop. Also tell me whether or not you think I forgot anything at my shop, whether or not there's anything in particular you think I should go back for to check out. I'm always open to suggestions for new books. Subscribe to my channel for more comic book content or check out any of the older videos I have up for offer here on Cat Run Figures. And until next time, I'm your host, Caitlin. Bye.